Yes, it is, Donna, and I guess the toughest burden any athlete can face, Juice, is being expected to do something. You can sneak in once in a while, and everybody says, gosh, isn't that wonderful, and, you know, how did he ever do it? But Lewis was expected to do it, and he did, and that's pressure.
Yeah, he was in a no-win situation because he's done it. Everybody says he should have done it, and if he hadn't have done it, they said he choked. But he did it in style, and he certainly has a lot to be proud of, and I expect to see some world records from him in the future. As I said, I'm sure we're going to get him in a meetup in altitude in Mexico City or Provo, Utah one of these days, and I think every record that he could, you know, have been here competes in, we'll see a new world record.
I talk about the fact that so many of the records are held at altitude, Juice. What makes the difference?
Well, obviously, you're talking about thin air up there. There's less resistance. In the longer distance, obviously, it's a little tougher. You have a problem getting oxygen in the lungs. But in the lower distances, because of the light air, you just can run faster and jump farther.
Good point. Calvin Smith holds the world mark, 9.93, and he did that at what we call at altitude. That was in Colorado Springs at the National Sports Festival last year.
And, of course, the record for this event was in Mexico City at altitude. As I said, the first leg should be the just about the only real competitive leg for the Americans because Sunday Nix is going to run against Sunday Ute. He won't be able to see him because Ute is in lane 7. And don't forget, we have a three-curve stagger here, so it could be a little misleading in this first lap and a half.
Set.
Sunder Nix to start off, and Armstead and Babers and Antonio McKay. The United States looking for a clean sweep, having already won both women's relays and having won the men's 4x1. And it's Nigeria in lane 7 that could give the U.S. some trouble in the white and green that is Sunday Uti running their first leg. And Egbuniki will be running their fourth leg. And also Darren Clark of Australia looking good in lane 3. Surprisingly, the West Germans failed to advance yesterday.
Well, you can't tell coming down this straightaway, but the Nigerians are certainly leading with another half a lap stagger there. Sunday Ute has done one heck of a job giving his team, I would say, about a 6 or 7 meter lead, even though he appears to be behind Sunder Nix.
Now remember, they have to stay in their lanes through the curve. So it's the Nigerian team. Moses Egbuosien is their runner. And also Australia with Gary Minahan. And the Aussies may very well have the lead, and they do, with the Canadian team. That's Doug Hines running for them, looking strong as well. But there is Ray Armstead running the second leg in third place right now.
Yeah, I'm going to be surprised if he doesn't what we call snatch these guys coming down the stretch here. I'm pretty sure that Armstead is going to give us a lead when we go into our third man.
Australia out in front.
Well, they've got one of them, but the Australians are running real well.
Running side by side with the Nigerians. And now for the United States, taking the baton is Alonzo Babers, who surprisingly won the 400, won the gold. He's looking for his second gold. He's in second place.
Once again, Babers has that long, smooth drive. He won his opener heat, really, on the final curve, coming off the final curve, and I think he's not too concerned right now. I know for sure that when we go to our fourth man, that the Americans should have the lead.
Well, you know how much Antonio McKay would love to have a gold medal draped around his neck after the disappointment in the 400, and there's the lead taken by Alonzo Babers, seeking his second gold, and Antonio McKay will take it around the track for the United States. There he is, good sized lead too. Doesn't appear to be a way in the world they will catch him. Australia in second place and Nigeria running third.
But once again, you're looking at one of the finest quartermen in the world, Antonio McKay. Antonio really runs better with competition. He's like Lee Evans. He likes to see his competition, and he's normally real strong coming down that final straightaway, but obviously would have to stop and turn around to see his competition here.
Antonio McKay on his way to that elusive gold medal in the relay. There'll be a great battle for second place with Great Britain and Nigeria side by side, and Great Britain with Philip Brown edging ahead. He'll win the silver after McKay crosses. Nigeria takes the bronze. Australia fades to fourth, and the U.S. has completed a clean sweep of the relay races. And so, the multi-winners, we had Carl Lewis winning his fourth. Chandra Cheeseborough won 2 in 1 hour. We watched Valerie Briscoe Hooks win 3. And And here for the United States now, Alonzo Babers has two, winning the open four and winning the 4x4. And McKay adds the gold to his silver in the open four as the United States wins the 4x400 meter relay at the Coliseum.